from NBC News. This is Today.
I got my own car. I got my own car here. Well, you know, because it's frigid everywhere in New York City, in Iowa, and it's only January, so the cold weather is definitely going to hit us hard. We are going to show you how to be prepared to drive in this kind of weather. All of us, you know, many of us, not many New Yorkers don't drive, but the rest of us do, and it's important to know a little bit about your car. So things like keeping your gas, never going below half empty, or the kit that you should have, blankets, food in case you get stuck, and things about your oil, all these things, I have no idea. So we're going to teach you all about that kind of stuff so you can be prepared when you get on the roads this winter. So we're back to you, Hoda.
Winterizing your car right after these messages.
That's the rest clean, right?
And you can smell it.
You can smell it burnt. It's like
riding along in my automobile.
And we're back with today's consumer and extreme winter weather care. And many states have already seen the extreme winter weather. And it's only January, so we got a lot more snow and ice are coming our way. So expert Lauren Fix is here to give us some suggestions on how we can take care of ourselves and our car and drive safer. Good morning, Lauren.
Good morning, Gia.
So you've got some great stuff, because I think, honestly, when it comes to car, like, I know what kind of car I like to drive, but other than that, I don't know much about my car. It's pretty intimidating for women, right?
Yes, it is. And so we're going to sort of take away all that intimidation and empower us.
Okay, good.
And this is good for everybody.
So we start with the owner's manual, right?
Now, whether you've got, and this happens to be a new vehicle, if you've got a new Enclave, yeah, you've got the owner's manual. But what if you don't? You have a car that's 10 years old.
Oh, yeah.
Right, so the Car Care Council is offering a free guide. They can get it through your website, and it's got all the information you need. So please don't go without getting the right information.
Right, so definitely get it and read it so you know what's going on with your
right.
car.
Right, and they also found that 70% of people don't prepare for winter.
No,
so they do these studies, and it's like the Car Care Council is saying 70% of people aren't doing anything. We have to get on top of this.
Right, that's a lot of people.
Right. So,
what's next?
First thing we're going to start off is oil. Now,
yes.
I know you may know how to check your oil.
I know how to cook with oil.
Cook with oil.
But let's see how you check it.
So let's relate with it.
Yes.
This is dirty oil. If you were to put that in a frying pan, you probably wouldn't want to eat
Correct.
With it.
Correct. You'd want to switch it out.
Right. So that's what you want with clean oil. And this is a time to use synthetic oil, because synthetic oil doesn't freeze. Like olive oil gets all chunky.
Yes.
Just think how hard it'd be for your engine to run
right.
when it's frozen.
Okay.
So that's why synthetic oil is a good choice.
Can you use synthetic oil for any car, even if it's 10 years old
yes.
or whatever?
Any vehicle, old or new, it's actually great for those vehicles. It's better fuel economy, better performance, better lubrication.
Okay, so we go with
next,
that.
Next, coolant. It has rust inhibitors in it. This is dirty coolant or antifreeze. This is clean.
Now, antifreeze should always be green. That I knew.
Right. However, there's new long life coolant that's different colors. That owner's manual has the answer for you. So
okay.
if you have a newer vehicle, you most likely do. Now, let's say I'm not going to change it. This is what happens. Look at the inside of this water pump. The engine will actually rust from the inside out. It has rust inhibitors.
So you wouldn't even know that.
You wouldn't even know that. And they're easy to check. Again, you can always get an ASE certified technician. You got to see that patch on their sleeve, and you got the
right
person.
So you can get someone to do this for you. You don't have to be able to do it yourself.
It's just like an air filter, real easy. This is a dirty one. Do you want to breathe through this?
Okay.
Your car doesn't either. Just
what's
like
this?
A furnace filter.
I love these little gadgets.
This is in case you get a check engine light.
Oh, okay.
And
you can check what's wrong with your car.
You can check what's wrong with your car rather than paying $100 and some for a technician to do it. You can get a bunch of friends to get in together. It's $79. You plug it under the dash, you get the code, and you know if it's a gas
going
or
on.
Something serious.
Okay.
Again, winter wiper blades are a great choice, just like we're wearing a jacket.
Make sure they work.
Yes, winter wiper blades. Otherwise, you can purchase a flat blade design. Like if you live in California and you tend to go skiing,
mm-hmm.
you can get the flat blade, one blade year round. Very good choice.
Okay, so make sure those work.
Now,
jumper cables,
hood.
Those I know.
Well, you know what the problem
is? So this
is
under the hood stuff.
This is everything in the car. I think the problem is people
are
scared.
So is this a kit that you were talking to me about?
Right, you
should have.
Add this to your existing kit if you don't have it. You know, jumper cables are a scary thing to ask someone, could you jump my car?
Especially for a woman.
Yes, it could be a bad invitation. So instead, you can buy these simple start systems. These are real easy. They plug right into your lighter. You press the button, start the car.
Is I'm getting one of these for my husband whose battery died the other day.
Around $50, of course. You want snow brush, de-icer, washer fluid. Tire inflation products, flashlights, LED light sources, which we have over there, better than a striking flare, much safer as well, which may become illegal in the States.
Okay.
Carry hats, gloves, scarves.
To stay warm, like someone like me gets in a car, something happens, and I don't have anything to stay warm in. Okay.
Right. Hand warmers and protein, some sort of food.
Okay, all right.
So all these things in a first aid kit, you know, carry water, things you wouldn't think about. If you get stuck and you have to wait. This is a much safer choice.
Food and water is very smart,
too. And blankets for everyone that rides in the car on a regular basis, and that includes animals.
That's right. And you know what? The thing is, this is just for women. This is for anybody who drives in extreme winter weather, right?
Whether it be a teen driver, and I have one in my household, you want to make sure you prep it for them.
Okay.
Make sure they don't get out there and be unsafe.
Thank you, Lauren.
Thank
See,
you,
now
Jill.
I know something about my car. So we'll be right back. But first, this is Today on NBC.